There's an idea that if Pokemon existed in real life, it would make everything way better. For example, you could go on a wonderful journey with a Sandshrew, or you could battle it out with a Garchomp, or find a legendary Pokemon, or cuddle up with an Eevee, and then give it a Water Stone to make Vaporeon, who is really good for setting up a slip and slide. But people tend to forget that Pokemon are actually terrifying. And here, I'm gonna rate ghost-type Pokemon in tiers based on how scary they'd be to come across in real life. This will be based primarily on their appearance, their Pokedex entries, and how much of a bitch baby boy I am, because I'm what a lot of people would call a coward, and I get scared really easily. Ghastlies tend to hang out in abandoned buildings, and they phase through walls and put people to sleep with poison gas. However, it's made up of 95% gas, and it gets blown away really easily, so just bring a fan if you're feeling adventurous. Haunter's lick causes endless shuddering until you eventually die, which is really unnerving, but I'm sure some people are into that. Sick bastards. Gengar brings a sudden chill and laughs at you while it's trying to curse you. Pokemon Sun entry is really fucking depressing. It just straight up tells you to give up. The mega form of Gengar phases through dimensions and even tries to curse its own trainer, so do not mega your Gengar. Gigantamax Gengar is a fat S tier, and I shouldn't have to explain how seeing Death's Door would make you shit yourself. Alolan Marowak dances to mourn its fallen allies, which is just more sad than anything. Mischievous likes to startle people by yelling and yanking people's hair, which is just rude, honestly. Galarian Corsola is just a depressing climate change version of Corsola, and it'll only curse you if you're in the ocean and kick it, so it's not even close to a threat. Shedinja steals your soul if you peer into its back, and it's also just a lifeless corpse bug, which isn't a reassuring Pokemon to have stick around. Sableye is literally a dwarf goblin that likes to eat rocks and gems, and it's said to steal people's spirits when its eyes glow, which makes it really creepy. Mega Sableye isn't able to move due to the large gem so it carries, so you can just walk away if you see it, and as a trainer, why would you want a Pokemon with such a heavy weakness? Shuppet eats up negative emotions such as jealousy and envy, and Ultra Sun's Pokedex entry states that some people are even grateful it's around, so it's the exact opposite of a threat. Banette is a doll that constantly searches for the child that threw it out, and I don't fuck with that. Just like Gengar, Mega Banette curses its own trainer when it goes Mega, so once again, why would you do that? Apparently, Duskull chases its prey at night until the sun comes up, and is told to bad kids that if they misbehave, they will be spirited away by Duskull. Now, if this was confirmed true, then maybe Duskull would be a bit higher. Dusclops pulls Will-O-Wisp and people into its hollow body like a black hole where there's no escaping from, which is a fat no thank you. Drifloon steals children away if they hold on to it, which is really fucked, but fortunately, according to Sun's Pokedex entry, you can counter it by just being fat. Drifloon takes people to random unknown places since they float aimlessly on the wind, so just don't ride them. Miss Magius' chants are like incantations that cause hallucinations, but sometimes bring happiness, so how bad could they really be? Spirit Tomb contains 108 souls inside of it and is bound to a rock to keep it from mischief. Personally, the only reason I find this thing scary is because Cynthia has it, and I have bad memories from fighting her in the games. Dusknoir acts as a Grim Reaper who receives commands to take people, Pokemon, and lost souls to the world of spirits. It uses its stomach to eat souls and spits out the rest of the body when it's done, so not any Pokemon you'd like to encounter. Froslass freezes people and collects them in her den where she uses their bodies as decorations. Now, I might be a bit biased because Frostlass is literally one of my favorite Pokemon, but I just want you to imagine for a moment you're out walking on a snowy day in the woods. Rotom possesses objects and causes mischief with them. I'm not reviewing the individual forms, but it's basically just a minor inconvenience, except it's also a Pokédex that's really helpful. I just can't bring myself to see this as being anything scary, so it's just sitting in F tier. Giratina. Yummask carries around the face it had from when it was alive, and that's depressing and also makes it a lot creepier than it initially appears. Galarian Yummask isn't quite as creepy since it's just a slab. Cofagrigus swallows up grave robbers and thieves that get too close to it. Unless you're trying to break into the Great Pyramids, you'd probably never have to deal with this. Frillish paralyzes their foes and drag them down to the depths of the ocean, which Doesn't sound very nice. Jellicent wait on the surface of the ocean to try to steal away sailors and is known to make entire ships disappear. Now you know that if you come across the Pringles man in the middle of the ocean, you're fucking good as dead. Litwick guide people through darkness while secretly absorbing their life force. In Pokemon Sword, it's described as guiding children to the spirit world, so at least it's nice in how it does it. Lampant loiters around hospitals waiting for people to die so it can come in at the last second to absorb their soul. So I guess it's not really a problem unless you're actually about to die. Chandelure burns its victims' souls and leaves their bodies behind, and the souls that it burns wander the world forever aimlessly. I guess you could say it's not very cool. Galette are clay golems that like to line up boulders, and that's just really cute. Galurk were created to protect people like Minecraft iron golems, which is fine and all, but it can fly through the sky at Mach speed, and that's awfully concerning. Honedge contains the soul of a dead person and sucks out people's life forces when it's grabbed, so just don't grab it, stupid. Doeblade is just a Honedge split into two, so you'd be even more of an idiot if you tried to grab these. Aegislash can detect a good leadership and find someone worthy to become a king, so try to grab this, because it's fucking cool. Phantump are made up of lost children's souls, and they lead adults astray in the forest. But at least with kids, it's just trying to make friends, so. Trevenant are chill with Pokemon and people who bring good vibes, but not so kind of people who like to burn down forests, so only you can prevent forest fires. Pumpkaboo guide wandering souls properly to the afterlife, so hopefully they can help any of the previous poor unfortunate souls other ghost types like the fuck over. And then they evolve into absolute assholes who sing the curse humans and take people straight to the afterlife. Like, what the hell is your problem? Confined Hoopa is just a Sigma male. Decidueye is a reliable archer, and I still don't know why it's a ghost type. Sandy Gas fist fights kids who take away its shovel, which would be funny on its own, but it also takes control of people who put their hand in its mouth, which is far less funny. Palossand pulls its victims down into sand and drains away their vitality, so unless you happen to have a source of water on you, you're good as dead. Mimikyu is quite a fan following, but you gotta remember that if you look under the rags, you die, so love with care. Delmise only like to kill Wailord, which is fucked for them, but they're just fine for me. Lunala is a moon boy. Lunala is a moon boy. Lunala is a moon boy. Lunala. Marshadow likes to hide in shadows and copy people's movements, and luckily all I do is straight goon and vibe, so Marshadow should be chill. I'll be honest with you, I didn't play Ultra Sun and Ultra Moon games, so I don't know what this thing is, but it might as well be S tier because I do not like how this thing looks. Sinistee requires you to drink it to steal your life force, but it tastes so bad it doesn't even work, you stupid ass teacup. Poltiageist is not gonna do any better, it's just a stupid ass pot. Cursola is just once again really depressing global warming stuff, so don't touch it. Renerig will show you haunting memories of the painting on it if you touch it, so don't touch it. Dreepy is so fucking weak a child could beat it up, and that's literally in the Pokédex entry. Now, Mama Dracloak, on the other hand, Mama Dracloak travels at 120 miles an hour to kick your sorry ass if you beat a Dreepy up, so don't. Dragapult launches Dreepy out of it at supersonic speed, so the prospect of death will at least be swift. Spectrier absorbs life force from sleeping Pokemon in the forest and has kicks that can separate soul from body, so it's pretty darn spooky. Calyrex heals other Pokemon and makes plants grow. So what a nice guy. And now for just a few technical Pokemon ghost type forms. Arceus becomes a ghost type when it's holding the ghost plate, which doesn't change how scary it is because it's a fucking god. Silvally is a video game console dog.
What the dog doing?
Dawn Wings Necrozma. I mean, Necrozma's just really cool, man. As a side thing, I did all of the visual recording for this video before they did the Pokemon Legends showcase of the new Pokemon, like Basculegion, so I'd probably put Basculegion around B tier, because he's a really big fucking fish. And that's it. This is the how scary ghost Pokemon would be in real life tier list. I should mention that this list is definitive and correct, so there's no arguing anything for any Pokemon to be moved, because it's already right. And if you disagree with anything, then you'll just have to subscribe and like the video, and then come to my house and argue with me in person on my slip and slide.